just a pleasure to be here, and I'm excited because I look at you, at the young people here, and I think about myself, you know, at your age and what I was trying to do and what I've achieved, and I want the same for you. I don't want you to have the bumps in the road that I had, but so we'll see if we can smooth some of those out for you. With respect to note taking today on what I'm about to say, I've only got about 15 minutes of information for you. You don't have to take notes because there's going to be a document sent available to you right after my talk. So you can just focus on what I'm saying and you don't have to really worry about writing it down. And what I want to say is, you know, this whole presenting idea, whether you're presenting, you know, your business idea to a team of shark investors or asking your Uncle Louie for a small loan, you know, what you say and how you communicate are critical to your success. So stack the deck in your favor. I always believe in that. And to do that, I want you to cover these 9 key elements in your presentation. Now, your coach may not have offered them to you, but I think that you'll find that these are all, in one way or the other, each coach is going to be encouraging you to cover most of these items. You know, many executives are good at their jobs. They're good at their jobs in their business, but they tend to wing it when presenting, which is good for me because it gives me a job as a speaking coach. But good speaking is an art. And part of that art is planning what you're going to say and how to say it well. As I'm sure that Will would tell you and Aram would tell you, there are no accidents. You know, there's no accident on the stage. I mean, there could be something that happens and it's how you recover. But it is usually well planned as far as what you're going to say and how you say it. So that includes defining your message and using storytelling to communicate that message, because storytelling is the best way to tell, to make a point. So as an added bonus too, when you cover these 9 points, your business plan will get kind of a boost. So you want to have these 9 elements in your business plan if you don't already. I will say that write your presentation, say it aloud, record it, edit it, rinse and repeat again and again and again. So, you know, with only a couple of minutes, I think, do you have 2 minutes? Is that correct? Just 2 minutes to make your case. Each and every word has to count. You know, there's no time for fluff and there's no room for boring presentations. So be alive and be energized and enthusiastic. You know, all emotions are contagious, especially the emotion of passion. So your passion needs to really shine through. You know, passionate people inspire others. Be the one who inspires this time. Okay, so let's get right into it. There's 9 key points that all investors want to know about your business. And the first one is the story of how and why you created what you're presenting. What's the pain or the problem that you're solving? Tell us a story. Mind you, make it a very short story, but tell us a story. So what I did is I made up an example of a company for this presentation. And it goes like this. Many years ago, I was in downtown Oakland and I saw something that scared the heck out of me. It was right in front of my eyes and I saw someone was nearly hit by a car while crossing the street. I saw a need, so I invented the crosswalk. Okay, April Fool's, not really, but it's a good story. So the second point is, now that I've told what the problem was, is the solution. What's the solution to this problem or this product? So you want to describe that briefly. How does it solve the pain? How does it solve the problem? What's it doing for us? So I would say, well, the crosswalk is an easy to use solution and it solves the problem of crossing the street safely. It costs the user nothing. All drivers recognize that it must be obeyed, and it's easy to install. Well, you might have the investor's attention now, right? So, okay, then tell us, is it working? So the third point is, what's your success to date? Have you solved that pain or the problem for the customers? Really? How many times? What's the feedback that you're getting? So I would say, well, in the last 20 years, we've installed 6 million crosswalks all around the world. And by doing so, we've saved over 1 million lives, including children and seniors. Consumers love it. Drivers, not so much. But it's the law, so our expansion looks good. So again, you've got their attention at this point. Well, what about the next question they're thinking is, really? What's the fourth point? What's your revenue? Are you making money on the product and service? Is there revenue yet? Will it be a sustainable company? Will the revenue be recurring? Do you have any contracts in hand? So Mr. Crosswalk is going to say, well, sure, our revenue stream is clear. We paint crosswalks and municipal governments pay us. After approximately 2 years, guess what happens? The paint fades and we are hired to repaint. It's a guaranteed repeated revenue. And at the moment we have 689,000 new contracts and we're doubling that every year. Now you've got their attention. Well then, what's the fifth point they're thinking? What's the market opportunity? How many streets are there? How many crosswalks are needed? Who's your target market? How will you reach them? At what cost to find acquisition cost for a client? What's the potential for growth? What are your sales projections and your profitability potential? And what are the assumptions that you used to calculate that profitability potential? And if you haven't launched yet, what's your proposed calendar for launch? So many of you have seen Shark Tank. When I say that, what are the assumptions? You've heard that people get shut down when they come in and say, it's a $1 billion market. And if we get 1%, and then the sharks go, yeah, go on. They stop listening at that point. So we want to know your assumptions. So Mr. Crosswalk's going to say something like, our target market is all streets currently without crosswalks. Okay. That's too broad. It's too big. We know you can't have every street, but I would focus it. So I'm going to say, but the biggest part of that market is the countries, the developing countries, because they have not seen crosswalks before. And there, the potential is 7 times that of the US, and at a growth rate of 600% each year for the past 2 years, and a profit of $97 per crosswalk, this opportunity is not to be missed. Now, with those numbers, if you don't have somebody sitting up on the edge of their chair, you've done something wrong. Well, then they want to know, wait a minute, if this is such a good business, then there must be competition. So the sixth point is your idea proprietary? Do you have a competitive advantage over other players? Is your intellectual property defendable or patentable? So Mr. Crosswalk's in a good position and he says, well, as the inventors of the crosswalk, we hold a patent on its design and use. Now, someone here is going to say, Larry, you can't patent a crosswalk idea, but it makes a great, great story for April Fools, doesn't it? But, you know, and also we designed the paint, by the way, and we hold a patent on the paint for the crosswalk. And 99% of city governments and 100% of state governments have made it a requirement to obey the crosswalk. Okay, this sounds good, better and better each time. So the next question that they're going to ask you is, who's running this show? What's the management team like? Is it just you? Do you have others? Are they experienced? Are they driven by the same passion for crosswalks that you are, Larry? And what skills and experience do you have? What skills are you in need of? Here's where you kind of lay it out on the table. So Mr. Crosswalk's going to say, well, we invented the crosswalk just on a whim when we saw that near accident. My uncle funded it, right? He was a shoe salesman, but he's transferred over to the company now and he's done well, very well for us. But we're in need of market expansion globally to get to these developing countries. And we need people who are experienced in that field in international sales. And I run the company on a day-to-day basis, so I don't have time to do all of that. So then the logical next question, again, you're just following through the logic here of what the investors are thinking, is they're now thinking, well, what are your investment needs? What are your funding needs? How much capital have you raised? Or how much are you looking for? How much do you need? And in this particular case, they're going to want to know, what will you do with the money if you win this contest? So Mr. Crosswalk's got it nailed. And he says, my uncle invested $101 of his own money, and I put in the rest. So in total, we've invested $800. And he says, our expansion needs are $250,000, $300,000 to fund our worldwide dominance. We'll use that money for a new CEO, a VP of global sales, and to fund a sales force. Now, the sharks are thinking, or the investors are thinking at this point, but wait a minute, what are you going to do? Oh, well, I'm just going to sit around by the pool all day. No, what you're going to do is you're running the day-to-day show, and that's what you just mentioned, so you might repeat that. The last point, the ninth point that investors want to know is, what's your exit strategy? Are you hoping to be acquired? And who would be interested in buying your company, and why? Or do you plan on taking it public? Do you have an exit strategy of any sort? So here's where, you lay it on the table and you say, well, we're confident in our revenue model. We believe that we should build the business until we completely dominate the market. And then we actually might be interested in selling. I mean, we hadn't really thought that much about an exit strategy, but we only want to sell to someone who's got good ethics. You know, these are specifics that you can add. And if going public is a good option, then we'd be open to that. But if it was me giving the presentation, I would say, I don't know much about taking a company public. So if one of you investors does, then we're happy to listen. Those are the nine elements to a key elements to a presentation that every investor wants to know. If you watch Shark Tank, you'll notice that these are the things that come up over and over and over again. So I'm just going to summarize real quickly. Think of this as a logical story that you're telling people, right? It's just a logical story. Well, I saw a problem. Number two, I found the solution. Okay. Is it successful so far? Yeah, and it's working. And number four, we're making money. There's a big opportunity. We hold a patent. We have some good management and some we're not, we need some. And this is how much money we need. And this is how we plan to get out. Those are the nine elements, key elements to a presentation. So, and we have that document coming to you shortly. And now I just want to go over, I have a couple minutes left, a few do's and don'ts of presenting. So first of all, we'll do the do's. And that is number one, be passionate. If you're not passionate, why should the investors be passionate? Be respectful. Always respect where these investors came from and what their history is and what they've accomplished. Be excited. You know, if you're not excited about your company, you're not going to get me excited about it. Yet be humble. You notice how in the presentation, Mr. Crosswalk said, well, we don't know everything. We don't know anything about taking a company public. Be honest. We really need you to be honest. And be friendly. Smile. Make eye contact. Now, when you're on the stage, right, as other speaking coaches here know, making eye contact is you can look actually at somebody. Here with Zoom, I think I'm looking at you at my camera, but some people are looking over here or looking over here. I have two monitors, so I could be looking over here. Make eye contact with us when you're giving your presentation. And next is speak clearly. Excuse me? Speak clearly. What? Don't make the audience ask. Speak clearly. All right. And now be aware of your body language. People always wonder, what do I do with my hands, Larry? Right? You know, when you're on the stage, it's harder because you can see your hands. With Zoom, you don't have to see my hands. But be careful if you put your hands on the desk, and then you bump the desk, the camera shakes. So be careful of that. There are other things with Zoom. So make sure the lighting is good on your face, not on your background. And be organized in your thoughts and presentation. And the reason I gave you these 9 key elements is they automatically organize your thoughts for you. If you just follow the story of the 9 keys, you will give a great presentation. You will cover all what's necessary. Fewer words are better. So you don't have to tell us too many words about a particular subject. And this is important. Know the answers to anticipated questions. Well, how do I know what those questions are going to be, Larry? Switch seats with the investor. Put yourself in that investor's chair and think, well, wait a minute. He didn't tell me about this, or she didn't mention this or this. Anticipate the questions. Come up with the answers to the anticipated questions. And if they ask you, great. If they don't ask you, doesn't matter. You know the answers. And the last thing to do is to practice, practice, and practice. Practice some more. And now just a couple of don'ts. Don't give us irrelevant information. So you notice how when I mentioned that my Uncle Louie was the one who invested originally in the company, I could have said, well, Uncle Louie, who lives in Nebraska, well, he was married to Mary and she was from Ohio, but actually her grandparents came from, we don't need to know all that. It's an interesting story. Wait till we're having cocktails together and then tell me the story, okay? Don't look down. If you're on stage, don't look down at your shoes. If you're on Zoom, don't look down on your desk, unless you've got a note. If you've got some notes here or something, you can glance down at them. That's okay. And don't mumble. No, speak to us. What? Don't mumble and don't speak too fast. Don't lie. Don't ever lie in a presentation. You will get caught. Don't ramble on or go off on these irrelevant tangents that I was talking about. Don't fidget. If you are a fidgeter, get yourself a fidget spinner and use it. Okay? Don't fidget. Don't interrupt. Don't interrupt until a question is wait till the question is asked completely before giving the answer. Don't make false claims. Don't tell us that you've got a whole bunch of business if you don't. Don't make up answers. If you don't know the answer to a question, say, you know what? I don't know the answer to that question, but I will find out because it's a good question. That tells us that you're interested in improving. Don't be cocky and don't wing it. Practice, practice, practice. And that's what I leave you with. Best of luck to all of you. Thank you.